Hello, folks, and welcome back to the Vertigo Tea Party, and let's play Elder Scrolls Online. Today's episode is brought to you by Travesty OJ. Thank you very much, Travesty, for your continued support on Patreon. I very much appreciate it. So, let's go talk to Velsa. I'm actually kind of hoping this quest line is a little bit longer, so we don't end up with a really kind of super short video. Not that I really have to do that. Come on, there you go. I think he was stunned, because he was going to attack, but then he kind of didn't. Alright, let's go talk to her. Oh, I guess a few things. Am I dotted or something? Oh, am I bleeding at the wrists? Oh, what was I going to do? I was going to try if I can see if I can use this thing. Use to learn the outlaw shields. Does it say there's any? Oh, okay. It's a book. Take a look. It's in a... I'm still bleeding out the arms. That's nice. We'll eat some flank steak just because. What else was I? Something I was going to do. Oh, right. I'd made some poisons just learning alchemy. So I think it's under consumable. That would make the most sense. Let's just use this one. It's worthless. But you have poison equipped. Your light, heavy, and light attacks. Heavy attacks and weapon abilities have a chance to consume a unit of poison and apply its effects. Weapon enchantments are suppressed while a poison is equipped and will not apply. Okay. Which seems a bit silly to me. That seems like, unless the poison is incredibly good, it feels like poisons would be very, like, far, far less useful. But that's just me. I also did install some other mods, just to kind of let you see what I'm using. Jalinar recommended some, and I went with a few of them. I grabbed both of the ones she suggested for the guild stuff, or the auction stuff, Awesome Guild Store, and the Master Merchant thing. ESO recipe list, I'm using that because one of my cooking things didn't work, and I had installed that Lua Memory Manager thing as well. So hopefully as I install more mods, the game doesn't like bog down or anything.
So, you got Silverclaw to spill a secret. At best, a minor accomplishment. He didn't send you to that powdered hornbill, did he? Buy a special uniform to fit in? You do know he gets referral for everyone he sends to that flax peddler? Even when he thinks my life is in danger, Silverclaw still works the angles. You bumpkin. Yes, I did. You're not supposed to throw my words back at me. Reminds me of Nicholas. I don't care if you are her protege. I'm not going to do Zira's scut work. I slipped a truth serum to Silverclaw's former overseer. I learned that Kosh blackmails assorted scum and draws them to Noshira Citadel for a meeting. So let's find out why. It seems Kosh contacts Little Fish from a position of power, threatens exposure, and bends them to his will. Elegant. What I'd do. But his connection to the Iron Wheel isn't clear. That troubles me. We. Now that Zira's protege is here, poor old Velsa can rest her weary bones. Find a way into the Iron Wheel's headquarters and learn how they're connected to Kosh. Oh, and blackmail needs documents. Be sure to swipe them. Zira tells me you're a thief. Go break into a place you shouldn't be. Take something valuable and leave before they notice. I did hear something about a passphrase for a service door. Look around, use your brain. I won't spoon-feed you. When you find what you need, get out and head back to the den. Don't get caught, and if you do, bite off your tongue before their torture forces you to shriek my name. You'll be fine. Nothing worth my time. And everything led here, didn't it? If we leave, we miss this opportunity to learn Kosh's plans.
Hang on, oh, this mission's super important. We don't want to fail this. Oh, well, can you tell me what you've learned? Oh, I'm not going to spoon feed you. It's like, well, I thought this was kind of important. Kind of, you know, be above that kind of petty squabbling bullshit, but never mind. Where's the fun if we can't have a little bit of worthless petty squabbling? I've been trying to keep my research going this whole time, just FYI. On different weapons. Oh god. Researching various traits. Ooh, Dark Magic 22. Nice. I actually got that where I wanted it to be. Oh, I guess we're not supposed to kill these guys. Blah. Oh, hey. Guess who we're killing now. Ooh, get knocked down. Ah, she blocked a little bit too late. Oh wait, no, I think we, wait, can we use the disguise here? I don't remember. Let's try it. I don't know what's up with all this stuff. Whoa, damn, that looked awesome. Oh, so I guess this is the area, because I know there was the one area that he said that, you know, you could not go to even if you were disguised as the help, because they did not allow the help here. And I'm guessing this is that place, since they're all showing us hostile still. But yeah, I am trying to keep all of my research going all the time. I say that, but then I follow that up by saying, well, actually, I kind of forgot to before I started this session, so here we are. Fuck it. Alright. Yeah, I don't really think there's even a point to being stealthy here. I mean, other than funsies. I'll take these, thank you. Get your ass over here. Got some skill points I need to use as well. It sounds like that guy was making those squeaky noises. I'm a basket. He almost bought it. Those guys over there, like, nah, everything's fine. Well, since that guy triggered when I, he got triggered when I stole that. I'm gonna guess the stealth part isn't that important here. I don't know, who knows. I'm gonna guess maybe that's the next area we're supposedly supposed to be stealthy. Do not pity the lawbreaker. Their fate is the inevitability of your solemn duty. A ring of iron around them. Wait, what did we even loot from that thing? I've already forgotten. Oh well. Is that a shield? Hell yeah. Can break apart shields later on. Get some sweet, sweet mats. As far as the mods go, I usually like to like add a few mods at a time. I don't like to do all of them at once. Oh hey, sup? Archer. Because if something happens, it's like, okay, I install like 7 mods all at once. And you load the game up and weird stuff's happening, it's crashing, you're getting errors, blah, blah, blah. And obviously, a lot of times it'll tell you. Flare traps pulse periodically, interacting with the trap while crouched between pulses disarms it, but be careful, being caught in a pulse will activate the trap. Well, that makes sense. Oh, okay, yeah, I see. Let's deactivate it. We should get experience for that, right? Let's wait for it. Nice. I don't think we got experience for that. Some BS right there. Yes. Killed her while the ultimate was still up. I was just using that for the hell of it. I don't really need to do it for any reason. Rack. Hell yeah, check out that rack. Sweet, sweet rack. Let me go over here for a second. Because that was a semi-important level. Because that opens up passive. But I was looking at this passive. It's not very impressive right now. Increase the duration of dark magic abilities by 10%. The only dark magic we're using that has a duration is the cape magic, which, you know, increasing it by like 0.9 seconds, almost a second, is pretty good. Crystal Fragments doesn't have a duration, and Rune Prison, I mean, it already lasts a long time. Making it last 1.5 seconds longer isn't going to make any kind of a difference. So, also not impressive. However, our Storm Calling's falling behind because we don't have as many Storm abilities. So, I'm going to drop one of our Dark abilities. Rune Prison's going to get rid of it. Well, I kind of want to level it up. What's the level 22 of Storm? Whenever you deal shock damage, you have a 30% chance to instantly disintegrate enemies under 15% health. Also not overly interesting. So let's do this one. I kind of want to get this stuff leveled up, is the thing. We'll stick with it for now. Negate magic, I want to get negate magic to 4 so I can morph it, because I think that's when we can morph it. And then I'll probably switch to a different ultimate so I can start leveling that up. But yeah, right now a lot of the passes and stuff are not overly interesting to me. The lawbreaker can deny truth, but can never deny fate. We shall reveal the greatest truth. The wheel turns ever onward. I'm gonna guess the passphrase will be some portion of these zealot sayings, these holier-than-thou shitheads sayings. Can't have a fantasy game without your zealots. You can't have a game at all, really, without your zealots. Crazy, batshit insane zealots. Where would gaming be without you? Alright, looks like it's over here. Ooh, 3 guys together. Sweet. Damn. Okay, that sucks. Hell yeah, 3 kills at once. Give me that experience. The cooking thing, or one of the mods I got changed this up a little bit, which is interesting, but I want to fiddle with that later. I haven't messed with it. Figured that would be one of the lesser interesting parts is me farting around with mods. Trying to get them to work. Oh, and it works. I'm just unfamiliar with how to use it. Be the better way to phrase that. Seems like those big barrels almost never are lootable. The littler ones, though, for whatever reason, we can. However, I mentioned it, but I also did increase my bag space. I'm up to 90 now. Wait, what? Nope. What the hell? What? Where'd that archer go? Heal myself up here. Ass. Is that like an ability he had that made him disappear? Or is he just a dick? Could be both. Or was I just not seeing him? That's also 100% possible. Yeah, because it seems like we could only really open the mini barrels most of the time. Guess we just can't reach our little lizardy arms high enough. Oh, whoops. Hiding spot. Who's stealthing through this? Come on now. That's easier, just murder them. What are there's like, does it reward you if you actually do it sneakily? Like, is there, like, other than just gameplay, roleplay type reasons, I'm curious if there actually is like a reason to do things more stealthfully in this game. And it, like in a case like this, I feel like sometimes you're fighting enemy or you're in an area where the enemies are just way tougher than normal. So that's your motivation to do that. But here, these are just like regular enemies, so. So who knows? And you're not gonna be arrested, so. What of the unrepentant lawbreaker? When shackles fail, take up the brand. All who meet them cannot deny. We burn our truth upon the canvas. Sound like the damn builders. Bow before the builder's might. Even the stone bends before the builder's hammer. God, those games are great. I need to go back and play through Thief 2 at some point. Because I had done Thief 1, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna follow this up shortly. Oh, you little bitch. How in the hell? The little AE hit him. That's fine. Ooh, he blew up. Have some lightning, Scarecrow. Ran through the lightning. Eh. I wish you'd have lived. I wanted to block that. Feel like a man. Alright, let's head on up here. Totally hidden, dude. Gotta make our game appeals to the kids, guys. Gotta use their language. What's down with the kids these days? Dope. Cuck, I hear that a lot on Twitter. Yeah, dude, I totally cucked that dude. I'm gonna guess I can't sneak past these guys. Oh, god damn it. Darn it, now I have to kill them.
Not in our house, dog.
What? The bounty hunter. Something fear is all around me. What? You lying motherfucker. I blocked that. Asshole. I so blocked that attack. Game, you're pissing me off. Not really. I'll let you have that one. But I won't be so generous going forward. Disable this? Or can we disable it? Oh, okay, so you... Apparently I disarmed it with my face. It's always nice. I'm trying to... one of the reasons I do that, by the way, doing that heal, even when I don't really need to, I'm trying to get in the habit of doing it. Like, being able to do it quickly, that way I don't really think about it, I just do it. I don't want to let my dreams be dreams. God damn it, I love you, Shay. LaBeouf. Terrible actor, and you are literally insane. But, love you anyway. That's how I live my life. I don't want to let my dreams be dreams. That's why I'm playing video games and talking to you people. Good choice. I'm just gonna walk right on through that trap. Because I knew it was down. It's not that I would just stupidly walked into it. Hell yeah, give me all the mats. Can I, You son of a bitch. One little tap. One extra little tap. Yeah, I was trying to pickpocket him. I wanted to get a little bit of practice in on that. Blocked it, but I think I was... No, that actually did stun him. Nice. Gate magic to that level. 4? Yeah. Not 44, but just 4. 44 would be nice. Damn it. Let's try to search that cauldron. Come on. There we go. Nope. God damn it. You know what? Screw it. It's just a drink. Who cares? I'm going to end up selling them for like 1 gold a piece anyway. 1 orin, 1 nugget, 1 ducat. Whatever this game uses, I'm going to sell it for one of them. Damn it. I was looking at the other side. God damn it. Wait, what? What's broken? the charge of an equipment. Ah. And no poisons are equipped. Well, just for now, let's equip a poison. I'm just mostly just using the poisons to use them. No real reason. Because I made them, basically. Because, yeah, I do know the staff's out of charges. Or was damn close when I was looking earlier. Where's our objective? Sorry. I was kind of getting into a murdering habit here. I see the trap there. Oh, it's below us. Fuck. All those people died for no reason. You seriously get stuck too often on these little things. Haha. Okay. Is there any way else to go down, or am I just gonna jump down? I don't know if there's like a ladder or elevator. Ah, there we go. Ow! I thought the trap and stuff would break my fall. That's why I did that. It's the only reason. Obviously, I saw it. Yes, give me all these materials. Man, I can't imagine playing this game without having the extra space. The inventory space.
What is the fate of the lawbreaker? What is the fate of the unrepentant? What of those who would deny their fate?
Blue. Wait, no, wait!
Enter and find peace within.
Well, is this a brothel now? He'll totally think I'm one of them. Is this where we use the disguise? Disguise is a costume of sorts, yeah? If you look at it a certain way. Hey.
I thought my shift would never end. Wait, who are you?
Don't hurt me! I'm not even an officer!
Give me all your apples and shit.
Thank the gods! You will have no trouble from me. You were never here, and I never saw you. I have a sleeping draught. One sip helps me through the night. The whole bottle will knock me out for hours. You'll be long gone.
I've got a whole host of sleeping, air quotes, spells. Wait. Air quotes, sleeping. God damn it. Way to fuck that up. By the way, should I ask why you're carrying around a potion that makes people fall asleep when you drink it? Should I be worried about you? Alright, so let's try to disguise now? I'm gonna guess it's not going to work. Because, I mean, this place seems even more guarded. So what was the point of the disguise? Somebody tell me. Because I want to know. Even though I don't really care that much, to be honest. But! Well, there's somebody over there. Search the rack.
This is your only chance to consider my proposal. Work for me, or else.
Or else what?
Or I hand these documents to the Iron Wheel. They do so frown on slavery and skooma peddling. Take a moment to consider your options. Well?
What choice do we have? Vrai!
Good. Then I shall make your documents disappear.
I already did that.
What? My papers were here. Did they fall behind the... I'll attend to that after my meeting with Chief Inspector Ron Beek. Do remember who holds your reins.
That went well, I think.
Ha, nice. I probably also wouldn't have said aloud, gee, where'd I lose those blackmail documents? In front of the people that you're, you know, blackmailing? I don't know, again, I'm not grand larcenist or anything, but just a rookie's perspective. Not that there was a hiding basket. That's a looting basket. All right, let's go spy on the Chief Inspector Rabink. Let's go ahead and learn that recipe too while we're at it. Tomato soup? This is the auctioneer thing, I think. That's cool. That tells you what stuff is worth. We need to use our food buff. Eat silently. Yes, just shove it into your face mask. Uh-oh, point of no return. Like how I'm sneaking here when it's completely unnecessary while I just bumbled about outside, loudly killing everybody. Got all this stuff to take. Why don't we just love picking... Oh my god, I was like, hey, that's weird, it's got a bunch of holes. I get on fire! Like, it takes my brain a second. It's like, that seems weird. Wait, no, stop! And my hands are like, what? Stop what? Oh, and here's the other thing about mods where it shows you, like, the location of all... Yeah, see, I see them this time. That actually might just be designed. But the thing about mods for things like telling you where the sky shards are... Yeah, it's just designed because I screwed that jump up. I don't really want to know where they are, at least not yet. Like, I like to try to find them, right? I'm fine with going back later on and being like, okay, you know, I've searched for them. I'm kind of tired of looking for them. I just want them for the skill points and finding them that way. But when I'm going through the first time, I want to try to find them myself, you know? Which, to be fair, I'm not really spending a lot of time looking for them. Just because I already spent a lot of time off camera just kind of farting around with, oh god, fire again, son of a bitch. I jump over the ornaments and then like stand in the fire traps. Good job. I'm the best thief. This is why I cast spells, not lurk in the shadows and take shit from people's pockets. I'm just gonna jump over everything that looks remotely suspicious. So yeah, that's why I don't grab those mods right off the bat. I did look at possibly grabbing the book one though. The one that shows you where the books are. Because the books are not quite the same thing. I don't categorize them in the same, same kind of, like, ooh, find the hidden stuff. It's more like, oh, this book was hidden off to the side of a room that you didn't search every nook and cranny of. Which is, again, not a bad thing in itself. I'm not meaning to imply that it is. Oh, jugged rabbit and press recipe. And preserves. Increase max health by 4,400 and max magicka and max stamina by 4,100 for 2 hours. Wow. Scales from champion levels 150 to 160. Small game, bananas, carrots, and frost Miriam. Cool. And I say again, I think it's really, I really like that idea. And this is like, it's one of those things where, a crafting motif. We'll look at that in a second. It's one of those things, like in hindsight, it's kind of like facepalm. Like, why didn't we think of that before? Where you can memorize a recipe that you can't use yet. I think that's great. And like I said, it's like, oh, that's so obvious that you should be able to do that. Which again, not to take away from the fact that they did it. Quite the opposite, actually. Like, oh yeah, it's a good idea, because it's just annoying. You know what it's like. Anybody who's done any crafting knows how annoying it is to carry around all those recipes that you can't use. They're just taking up a ton of space, and it's just frustrating. I kind of wrote those off as traps, but. Anyway, but yeah, so it's just annoying that it takes up so much space, and then like you kind of forget about it, and you forget to memorize it, blah, blah, blah. So it's really awesome to just be able to like, you know what, memorize this. You can't use it yet, but memorize it. That's pretty neat. I like that. That is a cool feature. Why am I still sneaking, by the way? You can't disarm these, right? Nope, nope, nope. You can set your lizard ass on fire, but you cannot disarm. God damn it. Oh, there it is. Suspicious relief. Hello. I'm not completely obvious right here.
I can locate Magnifica Falora's dowry. I can return it to you within the fortnight.
And what is your interest in the matter? Exactly.
The Iron Wheel must leave Hughes Bane. He is simply bad for business.
If you recover Magnifica Falora's dowry, I can guarantee our return to Tanith.
There is another minor request. Hardly a trifle. Perhaps we can discuss it over drinks?
I do not drink.
Then I shall take your share. Come, an office is no place to do business.
Especially with that strange lizard man staring at us through the grates. Anyway, after you. Escape Iron Wheel headquarters. Gee, I wonder if there's a bunch of guards out there. By the way, I kind of missed what was that conversation was about. Brain was sticking other places. Because it's a piece of shit. Okay. Oh, I saw somebody over there. Or did I? Nope. Wait, can I walk on these? Nope. Ooh, hello. Bunch of stuff that I haven't stolen yet. But I'm about to. I took it out your sack. That looks suspicious as balls. We're not going to step on it. You know, for being so lawful, you guys sure have a lot of traps. Traps are the work of the... of the devil? No, not the devil. Lawbreakers? I don't know. You shouldn't resort to them, is what I'm saying. Like you wouldn't use poison. You wouldn't download a car. Used to learn the Altmer crafting style requires rank 1 of any of the metalworking, tailoring, and woodworking passives. Nice. Got another style. Awesome. As far as I know, and... what is this? Iron Wheel Headquarters. This is to remind all Iron Wheel officers and soldiers serving within our temporary headquarters is an honor and a privilege. Those members of our command who would rather patrol the area outside the Citadel are welcome to apply for transfer at any time. Hot weather gear and rain slickers will be provided as necessary. Those who would rather remain in the cool, comfortable interior of this complex, please remember to comfort yourself as Iron Wheel, not common soldiers, or compose yourself. I think that's what that's supposed to be. Sneaking off into the secret passages will be seen as an application for transfer. Dangling your feet from the catwalk above the main storage area will be seen as an application for transfer. Be sure to ask Demi Lieutenant Atriana if dawdling was worth his time. Refusing to do servant's work in the interior will not be seen as an application for transfer. However, I will personally interpret it as a request to clean out the latrines, which haven't been maintained in nearly 2,000 years. Nice. So does this take us to the same place? Is this a different one? This is different. Let's check it out. Oh, I want to drop down there. Do not want to have to try to find my way back. Bananas. Yes, we have some bananas, apparently. Again, why am I sneaking? Yeah, I don't see anybody. I feel like this is one of those areas where you try to, like, right as you're about to leave, something happens and you fall to the ground and then there's a boss fight. Oh, I want to leave the sarcophagi. Alright, fine. Let's just leave. I don't see anything overly interesting there. God damn it. I just roll past all those. Be more interesting as well. I tried to roll, but he wouldn't roll. Prick. Oh, I got a buff for that. That's weird. You see that? When I... Maybe if I dodge right at the right... No, it popped up again. I have no idea. You saw that buff though, right? So yeah, I'm actually glad I split this off into a separate video. I did kind of think it wasn't going to be a quick thing. They were saying infiltrate the ultimate bad guy's base. What is that? Is that one of those new sweet dance moves? That's right over there. Seems like waypoint travel is a little expensive. Not bad. Damn you, vulture. Alright, let's hang out up here. Run until we hit an invisible wall somewhere. Alright. Try to avoid fighting too much over here, so we can work our way out. Whoa! What? How come he wasn't stunned? That's bullshit. Give me them loots. I think I was rooted or something. I don't know. Who knows? Like, just die. Don't bother stealthing, guys. Just run in and kill them all. Much faster. And in a way, cleaner. Oh, nope. She should be out here. God damn it. Well, that's fine. We would have wanted to come over here anyway. I know we don't have to go to the Way Shrines to port, but it's free. So I like not paying to travel. Free quick travel is the best quick travel. Whoa, easy. Easy. Probably be faster to get the Thieves Guild outside. The hell? Need to relax that ass. What's up with the cat pet I've been seeing? Like the panther cougar looking thing. Oh, Alexa. Where are you sneaking from? Maybe he's got a bounty and he's just paranoid. Thieves always hiding in the sewer in these games. Just like the rats they are. Wait, that's me now. Parts of these got I never go to. Up north. Complete opposite direction. I was running. I know it's on the map, but this place is kind of curvy. Fucking goddamn ass. Need infinite stamina in here. I'm still doing that weird
you
mouse
see,
thing.
Zero? Your protege returns having survived the invulnerable Iron Wheel. You should have more faith.
Everyone, clear the room.
Maybe me too, or... But this guy, he's standing here still.
Velsa told me you went into the Iron Wheel's headquarters by yourself. What in oblivion were you thinking? We're not ready to go anywhere near the Iron Wheel. I won't have anyone else die because of a choice. Listen, I'm barely holding this together. No offense to Quinn, but you're the best recruit we have. I can't lose you to a feud with Velsa. You're right. I shouldn't take this out on you, or her, no matter how good it feels. All right. You risked your neck and survived to tell the tale. Did you find anything we can use? Impossible! It's still in Magnifica Falora's family tomb. The dowry heist failed. Nicholas and the others died before we reached the treasure vaults. No, the Iron Wheel was here to punish us for attempting the heist. But if that's what you heard, were they really searching for the dowry all along? Why come after us with such ferocity? What else did you learn? Let me see. This is comprehensive. Elaborate details on merchant lords in Abba's Landing, as well as rivals throughout the region. Maps to stolen goods we could recover for ourselves. I'll go through what you recovered, see if it offers a clue to Kasha's plans, or anything involving the missing dowry. I need to make sense of all this. Get some rest. I'll need you ready when we make our move. And good job. I keep thinking about what you found. If someone stole Magnifica Falora's dowry, it wasn't the Thieves Guild. But we certainly took the fall for it.
Alright, I'm just leaving that so we can start that quest next time. So let's see. Storm calling to 21. Nice. Iron Wheel infiltration. Got some leg armor. Damn it, medium armor. That's fine because I'm wearing heavy right now. Armor's not as good, obviously. Max stamina, which is the least useful stat for us. Beast Mundustone effects, which is also not overly useful, I guess. Let's see, but we'll get a 5-set bonus. When you deal damage, you have a 25% chance to create desecrated ground for 5 seconds. Oh yeah, reduce the movement speed of enemies by 70, damages them for 790 every 1 second, and heals you for 100% of the damage done. Okay. We'll go ahead and put it on just so we can have the full set. I think that's it, right? Yeah. Awesome. Okay. I think that's all we really need to do other than the typical sell and all that crap. So I'll go ahead and do that now. So yeah, next time we pick up, we'll continue on the quest line and talk to Zero again. Wait a minute.
I keep thinking about what you found.
Let's go and talk to her again, because I don't think she is giving me another quest.
But we certainly took the fall for it. What about? Nicholas told Velsa he was planning a heist, but she retired before he shared the details. I'm the only one who knew. Someone must have followed us to the tomb. The merchant lords see the Iron Wheel as an occupying force. They fear Tanith wants to conquer Abba's Landing. Kosh convinces Chief Inspector Ranbeek to leave, he'll have immense influence. Must be his plan.
Okay, well, I went and talked to her because she obviously didn't have a quest, so. Looks like there's another one over there, but next time I actually might try that board, just to see what that's about, because we haven't done that yet. So, anyway, thank you guys for watching. Thanks again to Travesty for your continued support on Patreon. I very much appreciate it. Make sure you guys follow me on Twitter. Leave your comments in the comment section below, and I will see you next time.